how to do an emergency trach change. In some emergency situations, you will need to change your child's trach tube very quickly. Some examples include the trach tube coming out accidentally, also known as an accidental decannulation, the trach tube getting plugged with mucus, or damage to the trach tube, such as a break in the internal cuff or pilot balloon, or a tear between the hub and flange. A mucus plug is caused by thick secretions or not suctioning as often as your child needs it. An accidental decannulation can happen during trach tie changes, when moving your child, or from your child's movements as they become more active. This can also happen if the trach ties are too loose. Some signs that your child may be experiencing one of these problems include oxygen desaturations, or desats, trouble breathing, noisy breathing, retractions, their lips or face are turning pale, purple, or blue, they are fussier than usual, or difficult to wake up. If your child is on a ventilator, it may start alarming. If you notice any of these signs, first check that the trach is in the stoma by lifting your child's chin and looking under the dressing. If your child is on a ventilator, make sure that the circuit is connected all the way from the trach to the ventilator. If the trach is partially out of the stoma, gently push it back in. If you cannot push it back in, or if it is fully out of the stoma, try to reinsert the same trach that came out using the obturator. If your child has a cuffed trach, make sure that the cuff is deflated before trying to put it back into the stoma so you don't damage their airway. If the trach is in the stoma, try to suction and use a few drops of saline if needed to loosen the secretions. If you are unable to get the trach back into the stoma, your child doesn't improve after suctioning, it feels difficult to suction, or you are unable to suction, you will need to do an emergency trach change. Make sure your child is in the best position by laying them flat on their back, making sure their nose, trach stoma, and belly button line up in a straight line. Get the same size backup trach, make sure the obturator is in it, and apply a small amount of lubricating jelly to the end of the tube if needed. Undo the trach ties or the trach chain. You may need to use scissors or a chain cutter to cut the ties if you are unable to undo them quickly. Carefully and quickly, put the backup trach into your child's trach stoma. If you are unable to get the trach back in after two attempts, try again using the smaller size backup trach with the obturator. Once the trach is in place, secure the trach ties. If your child is on a ventilator, reconnect the circuit to the trach. You may need to give your child a few rescue breaths using the self-inflating bag before putting them back on the ventilator. Once their color and behavior improve, put them back on the ventilator. If your child has a cuffed trach, reinflate the cuff. If you are unable to get the trach back in the stoma, or your child is still in distress after replacing the trach, call 911 immediately. If your child becomes unresponsive at any time, immediately start CPR. If you use the trach that fell out, do a routine trach change once your child has improved. If you are by yourself, you can wait until another trained caregiver is available to do the routine trach change. If you had to use the smaller size backup trach, or you had a hard time putting in the same size trach, call the pulmonary clinic as soon as possible. It is very important that you have all the supplies needed for a trach change in your go bag and with you at all times. It is also helpful to have the trach ties attached to the backup trach tubes in your go bag to be prepared for an emergency. It is always best to have another trained caregiver help you change the trach. However, if it is an emergency and you are alone with your child, you will need to do it by yourself. Before you go home, you will practice doing a trach change alone, but with close support from your care team. Remember, during any of these situations, it's important to stay calm and change the trach as quickly as possible. For more information, talk to your child's care team or visit the website on your screen.